Hello, this is the RPG Chick, Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to a brand new Let's Play. Well, it's going to be a shorter one. This is an indie game released by Over the Moon in 2014. And they're actually working on a sequel. If I click that, it'll bring me out to a, you know, web browser blog page. So I don't want to do that. But, yeah, it's coming out quarter three of 2017. So I'm guessing that's the fall. So here are my settings. We've got anti-aliasing is just yes and no. So that's no developer commentary. I think that's apply. I think the screen is supposed to look like this. Because this is a helmet. What you're seeing here is actually, well, sort of a helmet. It's a graphical representation of such. But anyway, we'll just begin. This is like a, I don't know, like a semi-platformer shooter type game with text. And I'm going to be reading the text. Just so you guys know, I read all the things. So I'm going to be reading, you know, everything in the game. So it looks like we're playing version 2.31 there. This save data detected. That was my test. I played like 10 minutes in, so we're gonna ignore that and start a new game. Yes, override save progress. Now I'm actually going to just check my sound settings. One second, guys. Okay, there's actually no, if you notice, there's no sound adjustment, so I had to change the sound, the volume, and Windows Mixer to 70% so you can hear me over voices and sound effects and stuff relatively well. Yes, I want to overwrite progress. Now the interesting thing here, I don't know if you guys can see it, but in my test videos, when I play this back, I can see the not visible. Right now, as I'm looking at it, I cannot see the not visible. So I guess it works for me. For some reason, the videos come out lighter. And YouTube, I'll be interested to see if I can see it, actually, because YouTube tends to darken videos. So it might not be visible to you. Interesting, anyway. Yes. Do not turn off your system. So we're going through re-entry here. I am playing this blind, by the way, except for the first 10 minutes. I'm guessing a starship exploded, crashed, something. And we are plummeting back down to somewhere. Some world. Antimatter shield enabled. Which helps with that. So kind of reminds me a little of the game Limbo. But you can see the objects a little more. I think Limbo was like, everything was just black, wasn't it? I mean, I've never played Limbo. I've just briefly seen stuff. Minor landing damage sustained. Health monitoring system offline.
Biomonitor inoperable. Pilot unresponsive. Life support functioning. Basic Mark 7 system access routed to ARID AI. Primary objective, save my pilot. Accessing on-suit logs. Mission parameters and location data not found.
So, in other words, we don't know where we are, what we're supposed to be doing. And the pilot? I'm not completely sure if the pilot is in, if this is a suit that the pilot is in and is unresponsive and the suit is taking over, or the pilot's physically somewhere else, like a pilot of a space ship of some kind. A trail of blood and broken glass. Something was dragged through here. The other things, yeah, up here. The tunnel created from my impact. I can see stars in the distance.
Unknown. Weapon rendered inoperable from the impact. Consulting parameters. I will locate medical facilities.
Alright. Many hints on the fall are hidden in data nodes like these two. If you're not sure where to go, explore and read. So she interrupted. I can see stars in the distance. I'm approximately 50 meters below the surface. So I guess it would be helpful if we find our way to the surface. Unless we should be going further down or somewhere. So I'm a little awkward with this. Because you have to hold down the mouse button and move the mouse. Which I'm not used to. And who or what was that? A smaller pile of damaged synthetics. Many of these have been smashed beyond recognition. A robotic arm. The gripping mechanism is still operable. Now, we can interact. This is networking, which we do not have. Error. Network interface disabled. This is something we cannot do. Interact. Robotic arm. I went too close. It is still attached. A damaged control panel for an old garbage chute. There must be another cavern below this one. Perhaps there is another way down. It's here too. Some of these power systems are still giving off minute electrical signals. Yeah, and someone or something was here and jump up there. With relative ease. A micro wrench. This may be useful. Now, I only know from playing through the first 10 minutes. You can use the wrench on that. I will loosen this to remove it. I should be able to control the grasp. So now we interact with things. We have the arm. A robotic arm I pried off the damaged unit. That does not work. So notice the wrench is gone. I guess we don't need that anymore. That's nothing we can look at. Oh, that's where we got the wrench from. So basically, look at everything. This is a little religious here. This cloaking pattern is similar to my own. I may be able to network with it. But we can't. I cannot.
I require access to my networking suite. Attempting internal activation.
Press escape to check your operating parameters. Booting OS kernel, operating parameters. Must not misrepresent reality. Must be obedient. Must protect active pilot. Welcome to the operating screen. Here you can check the status of your different abilities. Exciting. Check your network interface. Select your network interface to continue. So all this stuff is restricted and the health monitor is damaged. That's a rude sound, isn't it? An organic superior officer is required to permit access. Automatic override will occur if this subsystem is required to prevent pilot death. So, we can't even try with the other things here.
Subsystem access requires authorization, but I may need these systems to safeguard my pilot. If I could find a way to bypass the lockout, I could override the access protocols myself.
Well, that's a good question. How would we even do that? Some kind of sensor there. A security panel. Its power cell has burned out. not. I like that. Now, if I go... There's no way past it, guys. At least at this point. An unpowered sentry gun. It is likely connected to the security panel. An abandoned security card. I can fit my hand through the bars, but still cannot reach it. And that's when we use the robotic arm. This will be useful. So now we don't have the arm, we just have the card. Security card I found by the elevator. So we're getting up to the point at which... Yeah, see, the car doesn't work on here because the power cell's burned out. The weapon's damaged, so... At some point I'll be able to shoot things and stuff, that'll be cool. So now I have this card. Oh, what's this? A simple winch. It is holding up these planks. Of course, the car is not going to do anything. Okay. So maybe if I... use the winch somehow? And bring that down? Because... Yeah. I forget. There's one other thing. Something about camouflage. I want to go into that. I'm not sure how I got into that menu. I still couldn't do anything with it. It was a camouflage type thing. The same as with the security, whatever. Oh, we got logs. I want to look at logs. Yeah. Camouflage system. It will basically engage if we... Is that... Can we... It will engage if it needs to. Why can't I escape out? Ah, that's not good. There we go. So I should be able to select those to get out as well. You have not yet collected any logs. Cool. So there'll be logs. Oh no. Return the game. I'm not sure how to activate this. Okay, whatever. I didn't get into the network thing before, but I did get into camouflage, so we can use that Christ-like figure to get data regarding camouflage. Now, I think I fell down here, I think. Yeah. We can also jump up. The control panel for this elevator, it does not require a key. Doesn't require a card either. Okay, blind now, guys, just so you know. I can't jump on that little ledge. Why would I want to, though, right? I don't know what that noise was. Or where it came from. Ahead, I guess, or above. An old metal pan, empty and relatively clean. Do we want a metal pan? Why not? A door control switch. There's a card here. There's a slot here for a security card. What if I try to use the pan? That does not work. Let me just, before we do anything else here, because you really gotta check everything in this game. Not that I could see, not in this area anyway. I'll use our security card. What are those? Don't... Oh. Hello?
Artificial life form. State your primary function.
Haha. Cool. I have options. Acquire data. Or issue standard. Let's issue standard greeting.
I am the ARID on board this Mark 7 combat suit. My intentions are peaceful. What is your designation?
Mark 7 ARID. State your primary function.
To acquire data?
Negative. Reveal your designation and intention.
You are being evaluated for depurposing. State your primary function.
Depurposing? Okay. Well, let's then issue my primary function.
My primary function is to assist and protect the human pilot of this armored combat suit.
Human occupant, please verify and validate the function of this artificial life form.
Impossible. He is unresponsive and likely in critical condition. I must find him medical treatment immediately. Can you be of assistance?
Evaluation failed. Unit unable to demonstrate valid primary function.
Well, la-ti-da.
Initializing neural format.
No.
That will kill more harmony.
That's not good. Intrusion detected. Pilot death imminent. Network suite required. Operating screen updated. Okay. So now we'll have access to the gun and stuff. And I will shoot the hell out of this guy. Network interface, attention. Pilot death imminent. Criteria for override has been met. Please activate subsystem immediately. So this is how we get our system switched on, because it's either that or death. Enabled. Can I enable these other things? Thrusters. That sounds cool. So I'm networking, which is going to help me. How exactly? Hit him with a pan? What am I interacting with? Oh, networking. Duh. Oh, cool, I controlled that. Nice. Well done. Once I knew what the hell to do. This terminal had a strong firewall. I was not able to network with it. Right, so it's not gonna work. I cannot interface with that. I was trying to hit him with a pan. With the remains of this being, I cannot find. 12 of the oldest trick in the book, we just stood on the thing. A crane arm with a network interface, likely used to control the remains of failed evaluations. Cool. I have a feeling I'm definitely going to be picking up The Fall 2. I was going to say Fallout. When it comes out. Pretty cool that It's going to be coming out soon. A crane arm. Of course we can't do anything with any of that stuff. Can I close the door with the security card? Nah. So now what do we do? We can network with things. Right. Anything we can network with, I guess. At least that's the idea. How can I interface with that? Well, we did once.
Self-evaluation initiated. Pilot exposed to harm while under ARID control. Logging recommendation for ARID diagnostic and reformatting upon return to dock. Edit role. Ultimately, pilot was not harmed and ARID networking suite was brought online. This system may be instrumental to ensuring survival.
So I think we're in the suit. Well, we're playing the part of the suit and the pilot is in the suit. You know what I mean. So when do I find logs? I want to read logs. So we can't... Yeah. Camouflage system. An organic superior officer is required to permit access. Automatic override will occur if this subsystem is required to prevent pilot death. So that's how we get it back on, because we, you know, we'll have to stop pilot from dying. Same with the motion accelerator. Power assist. Why are we blocked from these things? I mean, not in terms of a gameplay, but in terms of a story element, why are we blocked from all these things? I guess to prevent the pilot, so we're not using it in a, you know, an inappropriate way or something. This subsystem is online and working currently, so now we can actually interact with these things, which is cool. This subsystem has been badly damaged, is in need of repair or replacement. Cool. So I'm gonna look around, because... Oh, I didn't see that. Oh, I did see it. So I don't know why we have network. We can't network with the tunnel. So... I guess we just have all icons for everything, in other words. We can dig through with a pan. Nope. And what was here again? There was something... Right. Collect the blood in the pan. Nope. Well, so we've got other things here. Just trying to see if we can use the pan for anything. Can I network with this thing? Or interface, rather? I see you. Crawling over there. Oh. I didn't see the network thing. Cool.
Cease. Please identify yourself and your intentions. My inputs are inoperable.
I am the ARID on board a Mark 7 combat suit. My intentions are peaceful. Does your pilot require assistance?
I love this.
The human inside the suit is dead.
This is, like, fascinating to me. I love we can interact with these things, like converse. Acquire data of this. How do I...
Your design is pilot-centric. How did this human die in your care?
I was granted rudimentary control when my pilot's cranium was compromised. I do not know why she was attacked, or why we were hung here. I failed to protect her. No vital signs detected for 23 minutes. She is dead.
You are irrelevant. I will find a way to get you down. Then I will deactivate you and repurpose your power cell.
Affirmative.
How sad. Well, it's just a way of things, I guess. Yeah, you don't want your cranium to be compromised, whatever it's mission parameters.
I do not have record of this location or of my pilot's objective. Our deployment was likely for the same operation. Please disclose your human's mission directive.
State your pilot's clearance.
Fifth Quadrant Raven Division. Clearance level 7. 533172.
Process. Cool. Uh-huh. Clearance level. Not sufficient.
Huh. If I choose this again, is it just going to say the same thing?
I do not have record of this location. Our deployment was likely...
State your...
Fifth Quadrant Raven Division.
Processing. Clearance level. Not sufficient.
Okay. Acquire data droid.
I encountered a modified droid in some type of evaluation chamber. I am uncertain if its function is hostile or narrowly programmed. Do you know why it interrogated me?
Negative. You were not interrogated.
Have you encountered any organics?
The indigenous flora and fauna are aggressive closer to the surface. The only organic I have encountered here is the animal who took my sidearm.
Right. Okay. Right, we're seeking medical for our pilot. So wherever we are, like just saying this is Earth or some other planet, there are other suits and people that came from here, I'm guessing, or we all came from a ship that maybe exploded and he crashed down here. But why is he tied up on a cross like that? Most curious, perhaps, are these other beings that are around here, that like the one who interrogated me. So yeah, I need medical stuff.
My pilot is injured. Are you aware of on-site medical facilities?
Negative. We were not here long enough to complete our search. There is a large compound above this cavern. It has amenities for humans and machines. So basically, medical scanners and equipment would be logical.
A motion sensor prohibits access to the facility above. Do you know how to bypass it?
Use your integrated camouflage.
Yeah, which is not working correctly. Give me your gun.
Is your weapon functional? Mine was damaged.
It was. My pilot's attacker threw it aside while hanging us here. Before my observational system expired, I saw a small animal drag it through a crack in the floor.
Huh. It may still be functioning. If there is another cavern below us, I may be able to retrieve it.
The creature was drawn to my human's blood.
Nice.
I will return.